Shut up. that.
Well, a big thank you to you all for making such a big effort to come here. Not only is this a remarkable occasion, a lot of you have driven a very, very long way. I hear a number of you have done Land's End to John O'Groats, and I think that is really spectacular to have done that and then to have turned up to this event at the end of that huge mileage. It is, I think, now 41 years of you guys coming over here to Stanford, and I believe you were our first car rally ever. So isn't that fantastic to see you not only back again, but back again in such strength? And we went up on the roof just about 15 minutes ago to take a photograph of you all, just as the sky was clearing a bit, and we counted 64 cars out on the grass here, two tractors, and a Lea Francis push bike.
But of course, today is a wonderful day. Being 50 years, oh, sorry, can you hear me? Since the inception of the club, when a few members got together 50 years ago, they met at a pub called the Albert and decided to form the club, which was great, and it's expanded ever since. And we've now got over 300 members, which is terrific. And we therefore have all these lovely cars here as well. And it's really made our day. We haven't noticed the rain, I'm sure. We've got a wonderful committee and people who organise these events. Eugene and Peter and family have done wonders today. It's been a terrific meeting. And so I thank everyone who has been concerned with it. Well, I just wish you all the very best and thank you very much for coming, and get home safely.
Unbeknown to some of the committee members, it was decided that awards should be given to those members who had made a particular service, a long-standing commitment to the club. And I'm pleased to say that they're all here today as well. They're specially cast radiator caps in front of me. You see them, the horses, the leaf, the uni horse. And then what I'd like to do is ask Tom Delaney to receive his award, please, for long service to the club. Award goes to Keith Poynter, our chairman. The third one is to a gentleman who edited the leaflet for 18 years. He'll probably tell me I've got that wrong, but I don't mind, Alan. Alan Lumpton. Fourth of these goes to a gentleman who spends quite a bit of time with Lea Francis and always seems to be just getting another one ready. He's well known to most of us. His name is Barry Price. Barry.
Heavy and nice. Put it on the mantelpiece.
Barry, can you turn around?
Barry. Who has put a tireless amount of energy into the club and has spent a long time making sure that things are right throughout the club. His name is Robin Sawyers, as our secretary. this. I didn't say anything about it, but then it was suggested it should happen. It's to my father, Peter Baston.
Deserve some awards. The Jubilee book, which I hope you're all going to buy or have already made your order, has been a really mammoth task for the three people who've been most involved in it, and I would like to see that rewarded. So Eugene, please. As some of you know, I've been in this club from the very beginning, and I suppose in a way from before the beginning. From that January announcement that there was an idea to form one. And I have met so many friends in the Lea Francis Club compared to other clubs to which I have belonged. And I would like to thank all of you. I'm sorry if I haven't spoken to you, or with my bad memory, I don't know your names. I'm especially grateful to all of you who've come from overseas to here, because I am so concerned that we are a worldwide club. And it's lovely to see our Australian friends who otherwise are just letters or names in the magazine. And likewise too, our friends from America and other countries in Europe. And if I haven't seen you today, I'd like just to shake your hand before you go, please. Thank you very much.